House Republicans accomplished something this week. They have passed a new set of rules to govern how the Office of Congressional Ethics is going to function. And the end result of it is that it is going to be incredibly difficult for that office to continue to provide oversight on ethics violations of members of Congress. And so if you're wondering, who are they there to protect? The answer is clear. First and foremost, themselves. They do not want to be investigated for violations of the Stock Act, insider trading, any of that sort of stuff. That group, by the way, the Office of Congressional Ethics, is tasked with investigating any allegations of misconduct against members of Congress. It then makes a determination as to whether those allegations are worth investigating further, at which point it makes a referral to the House Ethics Committee. So some things that have been investigated recently by it include several Republicans related to Stock Act violations. There were fines against former Representative Madison Cawthorn for improperly promoting a cryptocurrency. And there was a case opened against Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, we believe, over the Met Gala dress or something related to that. So it's a semi-independent body that investigates both Democrats and Republicans. But the most important word there is investigates, and that's not what these Republicans want. But while I don't like this news, there is one individual who's quite happy about it. George Santos says, "I think it's fantastic." Well, what do you know? The dude who's lying constantly likes that the body that would investigate ethics violations is gonna have a lot of trouble working going forward. Yes, it's good to see like good news for George Santos finally.
George Santos, I feel like every time he's in the news for something, it just gets more and more ridiculous. I hope that maybe, you know, they keep comparing him to that actor, Robbie McBaron. I hope maybe he can like snag a recurring SNL gig out of all this. And maybe that would be like a way that Congress actually gives something back to the people. But as far as like between this and what they're doing with the IRS, it's so obvious what they're doing. And I don't know how any voting American could see this as a good thing. The only reason that I can think of is that they think congressional investigations are a waste of taxpayer dollars. But if there is sufficient evidence to merit an investigation for something, it's better for everyone in the long run. It's better for the country that wrongdoings by government officials are looked into. It's like what we were talking about earlier. Look into the stuff that seems shady.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, what constitutes sufficient evidence is a highly political topic, even when it shouldn't be. And you would think that facts and data and history would hold some weight in those discussions, but it just, none of them really seem to matter to a lot of people. Yeah.
100%. Really fast to describe what they're changing and how that's going to affect how the office functions. So it reimposes 8-year term limits for the OCE's board members made of former members of Congress. You might think, oh, well, they said they were for term limits. No, but understand, they're not for it because they want term limits. They're for it because of what the imposition of term limits would accomplish immediately. The practical effect would be the immediate removal of 3 of the 4 Democratic appointed board members. So they'd be gone immediately, which would make it so that they wouldn't have a functioning body. Now, eventually appointments can be replaced, but that could take months. And who knows how many illegal acts can be conducted by Congress in that time. Also, the rules prevent the office from hiring new staff after 1 month and require 4 board members to sign off on any staffing decisions, potentially allowing them to just filibuster literally any staffing. Now, why would that matter? Well, because the investigators are staff. If you stop them from hiring investigators, then the body can't function. This is so incredibly transparent. They just don't want to be investigated. Now, all of these things make it harder for the body to work. But George Santos doesn't want you to worry. He says, I think it just gives them more power. If he really said that, I don't know. We think we were talking to George Santos when we got that statement, but maybe it wasn't him. Anyway, the whole thing is so transparent. They want to stop effective taxation on the rich. They want to stop investigations on them. When they had been pressing Nancy Pelosi to do the ban on individual stock trading, we said, pretty sure that that's just them trying to score points, that they're not actually going to support that once they get into office. And you'll notice that they have not pushed for that. And it seems like if you're trying to make the Stock Act impossible to enforce, you're probably not going to push for that stock ban. But maybe I'm wrong, Yas. Maybe they'll eventually do it.
The quote from George Santos, who like, I don't know, I think it gives them more. I feel like on programs like this one, I go out of my way to make sure that the things I'm saying are backed up with evidence, or I read it somewhere and like it's sourced, right? Like I do that work for everyone watching right now. But these Congress people are just like, I don't know. I think it's fine. I think it's good. And then that's it. Who cares what George Santos has to say about anything at this point? I don't know why he's even saying any. If I was George Santos, wouldn't it be better to just like not be commenting right now and like kind of lay low? But that's not what we're seeing.
Also, I just want to show this graphic 7 for two reasons. One, just because we don't have time to talk about it, but I want to make sure that you know that one of his paid campaign staffers pretended to be Kevin McCarthy's chief of staff to raise money, which is just chef's kiss that a guy hired by George Santos is pretending to be someone else. But also, if you're George Santos, can we go back to that picture? If you're George Santos and you're going to be constantly lying in a way like about the Holocaust and 9/11 and all that, don't allow yourself to be photographed doing the evil like Mr. Burns hands. Like, you're making it too easy for us at that point. Just do normal stuff, maybe.
I don't think he even knows what normal is anymore. I think normal is just like so far gone, so far behind him that he's just this person now sitting in Congress of all places. So this is going to be an interesting year.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.